Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday, as expected, SpaceX launched the second crew mission for Axiom Space with the Axiom 2 mission.
One, engines full power, and lift off Falcon 9, go Axiom.
It's one alpha.
Copy, one alpha.
Together we expand what is possible in low Earth orbit. Ad Astra and Godspeed AX2.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the first time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
Beautiful view of planet Earth coming to us from the second stage views on the right-hand side. Left-hand side, our first view of the Space Coast once again. This booster is attempting a landing at LZ-1.
Stage 1, transonic.
That booster is now traveling near the speed of sound. Live view coming to you from one of our tracking cameras. We can see the grid fins actuating to help steer the booster down.
Stage 1, landing burn.
Stage 2, FTS has saved.
Standing by to...
Stage 1, landing leg deploy.
There you
can... Stage 1, landing confirmed.
You can see that first stage has landed back at LZ-1. This is the first time that we have performed a land landing on a crew mission.
There was supposed to be a Falcon 9 launch this morning and SpaceX got down to around 3 minutes in the count before calling off the launch due to weather. The launch of the BADA 8 mission is now scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 25th at 3:25 a.m. UTC or today, Wednesday 24th at 11:25 p.m. EDT. There was a tweet posted related to Starlink satellites being sent to Italy. It says Starlink can be rapidly deployed to provide immediate connectivity for those in need. With more on the way, 150-plus Starlink kits arrived overnight in Italy's northern Emilia-Romagna region to support rescue and recovery efforts from severe flooding. Heading to Boca Chica, more rebar was installed for the orbital launch mount foundations. The back piece of the booster quick disconnect was removed. It was also moved away from the launch site. The Starship quick disconnect was seen being removed from the arm. There is construction work going on around the old landing pad. With all the work going on with new buildings at the Starbase production site, there are quite a lot of changes coming. Zach Golden posted a tweet which shows what changes we can expect over the coming months, confirmed by Musk with a tweet saying yes. It says, everything shown in red is in the process of being disassembled. Green is in beginning of phase 2 of Star Factory expansion. Assuming that Star Factory will extend into the areas currently being cleared, this will be absolutely massive. Here's a look at the progress on the new high bay sections. They are now installing panels. There was an article posted related to an environmental lawsuit after the Starship launch. It says SpaceX is set to join the Federal Aviation Administration as a co-defendant to fight a lawsuit brought by environmental groups following the company's first test flight of Starship. There was a tweet posted related to possible HLS components that have been spotted at Starbase. It says there are three speculated parts for the HLS lander shown below. First image, forward dome adapter. Second image, some sort of support floor for the crew compartment. Third image, elevator assembly. Work was seen going on inside the Ship 25 prototype as they prepare it for more testing. As always, I have to say thanks to Chris Kleindl for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.